President Cummings, Dean Qualls, distinguished faculty, and to our amazing students and your family, friends, and guests, it is my great pleasure to welcome you to our December 2020 USM School of Nursing Pinning and Convocation Ceremony. I'm Brenda Peterson, Associate Dean of the School of Nursing, and we gather together today to engage in an important celebration. As the COVID-19 global pandemic has called upon us to adapt, we hope that this event will be a meaningful reminder of a time in life that we did not anticipate when you began this journey toward becoming bachelor's prepared registered professional nurses. In the midst of a global pandemic, we take this time to celebrate each of you and your place in healthcare history. As we begin, I want to take a moment to express heartfelt thanks to Wendy Murphy and to our convocation committee, and to our class marshals, Julie Bell and Ashley Barron, who have been selected by their peers for their leadership. Thank you, Wendy, for your vision and for all of your work in actualizing this event and making this a meaningful experience. We recognize our esteemed and valued faculty. Without your innovation, expertise, commitment, and support during our students' academic journey, this event would not be possible. We thank our staff as well, who have provided each of us with so much support. As nurses, we stand on the shoulders of giants. 2020, International Year of the Nurse and Nurse Midwife, celebrating the 150th anniversary of the birth of Florence Nightingale, who is remembered and celebrated as her work has laid the foundation for our professional practice. Her wisdom continues to lead us forward today. 2020 is used symbolically to describe clear vision. We also say that our hindsight is 2020. May we each be able to look back at this year with hindsight that will lead us ever forward. As you leave USM School of Nursing, you take with you the knowledge, skills, and behaviors that have prepared each of you to lead healthcare forward. During this extraordinary time of the COVID-19 pandemic, your strength and your resilience has inspired us. You have made many personal sacrifices during your long days and nights of study. Your passion, commitment, and caring for others is truly exemplary. 2020 will forever be remembered for not only COVID-19, but also for the rising up of voices across our nation, calling out for racial justice and an end to the oppression of marginalized and oppressed groups. And you, our students, have helped to lead our School of Nursing on a transformational journey, leading us forward and ensuring that USM nurses are prepared to address the systemic barriers, ensuring quality and safe healthcare for all. And as we celebrate each of you today, let us also remember the words of Florence Nightingale, who said, "Rather 10 times die in the surf, heralding the way to a new world, then stand idly on the shore. I attribute my success to this. I never gave or took any excuse." We hope that you will enjoy this event as we recognize each of you and celebrate your achievement. And it is now my great pleasure to introduce President Glenn Cummings, who will offer his remarks. Thank you so much, President Cummings.
Hello, I'm Glenn Cummings. I'm the president here at the University of Southern Maine, and I am here to welcome you to USM's December Nursing Convocation Pinning Ceremony for the graduating class of 2020. Congratulations. Thank you to the parents, the family members, the spouses, significant others, friends, and most importantly, to our graduates who are here with us today. I'd like to begin by recognizing our keynote speaker today and the immense work she has done in keeping USM safe. Lisa Belanger has spent countless hours, nights, weekends, and infinite amounts of painful administrative meetings with me in them, devoted to our students, our employees, and community. She sets the precedent we strive for, and I could not thank her enough. She is the epitome of what a great nurse is. Get to know her. Additionally, I'd like to acknowledge the other speakers that we will be hearing from tonight. Dean of the College of Science, Technology, and Health, Jeremy Qualls, the Dean of Students, Rodney Mondorf, and the Associate Dean for the School of Nursing, Bren Peterson. Our marshals tonight in the program will be Julie Bell and Ashley Barron. We're happy to welcome also Crystal Austin, RN, the Clinical Coordinator for CHANS, our home health care and hospice program, as well as the president of the Student Nurses Association, Rachel Keeley, and we thank you all for doing and joining us tonight and doing your work with us tonight. As we head into the winter, the number of COVID cases in our country and in our state is rising dangerously. The need for nurses could not be more apparent at this very hour. I am proud to say in you, we have over 60 new nurses ready to enter into the field, prepared for all the challenges and the triumphs ahead of you. This feat is a direct reflection of your character, your hard work that you have done, and the sacrifices that you have made and will make. When you started on this journey, you joined an elite group with a rich history. Through the rigorous course of study, hours spent in classes, labs, and in the library, you fought for your degree, and you won today. You exit USM not only with the lessons learned from the classroom, but also the real-world experiences you've had in clinicals, working in the community, and I thank you for giving yourself wholeheartedly to the program, to the profession, to our state, and to our country. The work you have done and will continue to do outside these walls will make a lasting impact that will reverberate far beyond where we are today. Although no one knows where we will be or what the world will look like, I am confident I can say that you will be a part of shaping that future. Though your time here is at an end, know that you are forever woven into our fabric as a Husky and now an alumni. 2020 may have been labeled the year of the nurse, but we know that every year is the lasting hashtag year of the nurse. We wish you the very best. Thank you for coming here, taking advantage of our program, and going out and serve the many people who need you. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Jeremy Qualls. I'm the Dean of the College of Science, Technology, and Health. I'd like to say welcome and congratulations. What you've done is a milestone. It will impact not only your life, but all of those around you. I want to take a moment to share with you three things that I hope will help you in your career as you advance forward. So first off, I would really highly recommend that you schedule in and put in time for me time. Take me time. Take time to appreciate the little things, appreciate what you have. Take walks. Make a new friend every day. Find that balance between personal life and work life. Second thing that I would like to bring, listen. Always be open to new ideas and growing. Many times you'll hear a voice that warns you, I should have done this or that. And it's true, you should listen to that voice. It's a good voice. I personally have a habit to procrastinate. Sometimes I don't put gas in the car or fill the tires up, and then it comes back on me. But there's always that voice that warns me that says, oh, by the way, you need gas. So what I'd ask you to do is listen to that voice and always be open to things. The third thing that I like to bring up is bad things happen. They'll happen to you. They'll happen to the ones you love. And it's really no one's fault. In particular, it's not your fault. When this happens, you'll have to ask yourself how you're going to react. Will you do it with compassion? Will you do it collectively? Will you be part of the solution? And I ask that you do. Always look forward to the future and try your best. Moving forward, again, I'd like to extend a fond congratulations to you and your family. And if you ever feel like reaching out, remember that the University of Southern Maine is always your home and your family here. Thank you very much.
Congratulations on a fantastic accomplishment. And as Dean of Students, I'm usually able to look out at the audience and see your faces and smile and start to reminisce on some of those memories we've had on campus where we've passed each other, or you're wearing your blue scrubs at the dining hall and I ask you how things are going. And this year, it didn't happen. But what I did know, or what I do know that's happening, is that you got a great education, you put yourself out there, and you accomplished an incredible task. And for that, I congratulate you. It's been a weird year, and so I've, you know, kind of doing it this way is not one of my fortes. But what I want to do is I do want to leave you with a message. I want to leave you with something to think about. Is that you accomplished something great. You earned a degree. But the degree isn't what's going to make you great. The degree gave you the tools to be great. You need to make yourself great. And I can tell you that from my personal experience of having a number of USM nursing students taking care of me over the last year when I had my medical condition, you've got the tools. You can do this. And so now is the choice is up to you. Are you going to be great, or are you just going to be? I challenge you, because I know that all of you looking on the cameras at this today can be great and will be great, because USM is great and we have a great nursing program, and you did it. And for that, I congratulate you, and I look forward to seeing you out and about in your scrubs, walk in the hallways at the hospital, and if you see me, say hi. Hopefully I'm walking this time and not lying in a stretcher. But for all of you, the hard work you did, and probably in one of the most challenging years, you should feel proud. I do. On behalf of all the other students and faculty and staff, congratulations on your success.
Thank you, nursing graduates, for inviting me to be part of this celebration. It's an honor to join you on this day, and my sincere congratulations to each of you. I know there was plenty of hard work, lots of uncertainty about the future, and abundance of flexibility required of you to complete this coursework. What I'm going to offer you are a few thoughts about things that I have learned during my nursing career that I hope might be helpful to you. I call this learning and living life's lessons, and plan to share a few stories from different places where I have worked over the past 40 years, along with the important lessons that these experiences have taught me. Here goes. Lesson number one, facing your fears and failings. As a new graduate, this was 40 years ago, I was 22, working on R4, which at that time was a rehab unit at Maine Medical Center. And one of my first patients was a difficult one, a difficult patient who was argumentative, uncooperative, didn't like the food, didn't like anything that was offered, and had also been in a terrible accident that had rendered her a quadriplegic. At that time, I was so concerned about how I was doing the technical part of my duties, how well I was getting her to her therapies, that I really didn't look at the person that was in front of me. I now know that part of it was my fear. She was of a similar age as myself, and I saw myself in her. So the understanding of that and recognizing what that fear was important in order for me to be more empathic. I'll offer that there's something called the Johari window. The Johari window says there's a part of a window pane that's open. It's the things that I know about me and you know about me. There's another pane of the window that's called blind spot. It's what I don't know about me, but you do. Another pane is I know something about me that you don't know. That's the hidden. And finally, the mystery. Both you don't know and I don't know that particular thing about me. What I want you to turn your attention to is the blind spots. Because although they are sometimes painful to hear, if you can find a good and trusted friend or family member to share what they know about your blind spots, consider it a gift. Because if we don't recognize our blind spots, how do we learn about ourselves and how do we learn from our mistakes? Invite those that you trust to share what they know about your blind spots. Lesson number two, surviving the strict standards of silliness. We know every institution has them. All large institutions, I've worked in many, recognize them for what they are. There's many times that you'll see in the slide that I'm offering that it seems obvious what the solution is. Wash your hands. But we have to go through a whole lot of processes to get to that point when the obvious is there. Every institution that you will work in, large institutions, will have these strict standards of silliness. If you can't fix them, if you can't correct them, if you have no control over them, just recognize them for what they are and move on. Just knowing that, yes, it is what it is, and we move forward regardless. The strict standards of silliness. Lesson number three. Keeping an incorruptible compass. This was a learning that came while I was working at Public Health, where I worked for better than 26 years. And at the time, my job was to oversee the work of the school-based health centers in six of the schools here in the Portland School District. At the time, I was working as a nurse practitioner also at King Middle School. And there was an alarming uptick in the number of young middle school students who were getting pregnant. So in collaboration with a very important figure in the school system's history, Amanda Rowe, who is the head of the school nurses, with the school board, with a number of parents, with the blessing of the community, we move forward with offering contraceptive services to those middle school students at King Middle School. What happened later? What happened as a result was a firestorm. It went viral in terms of the press, and we, for weeks later, were under scrutiny from a number of different lenses. But we stood firm, and we stayed the course, because doing the right thing for the right reason, in the right way, is essential. Anything else is not really staying on a compass that is moral and right. So find your heroes, think about them in those times that are difficult, and think about what they would do if you're questioning what the next step might be. Do the right thing for the right reasons and in the right way. Lesson number four. Probing for pearls in a pandemic. Working at USM since March has been a challenge. Long hours, endless number of phone calls, texts, and emails, daily fighting of fires, no regular schedule, no longer able to see patients on a regular basis, delivering meals, picking up laundry. It's an endless number of logistics. I would have never imagined some of the things that we're being called upon to do. But it's stressful, yes. Chaotic, yes. Painful sometimes, yes. But there are also pearls that I would share with you that I've taken away from this experience. It used to be that I was behind closed doors a good part of the time, seeing my patients, which was a pleasure, and working very closely with the team of people that I worked with. But I did very little interacting with other members of the USM team or other members outside the USM team. That has changed, where I now have a lot of people that I call close colleagues and friends that I've come to know as a result of this pandemic, and only because of this pandemic, and what a gift that has been. I'm more mindful now, more grateful for the small things. I pay greater attention to the sounds of birds while walking, appreciate the time I have with my family, even though we might be doing nothing in particular. I am spending more time in the moment, those moments that I have. Yes, stressful, chaotic, isolating, and sometimes painful, but it gives you an opportunity to see what you're made of. Who am I under pressure? What valuable things am I going to learn about myself as a result of this? For me, I have learned I have need to be needed. I want to leave the planet knowing that I have contributed something good in exchange for all the good that has come my way. I have clarity of purpose. I have meaning. I have avocation. Winston Churchill once said, "The pessimist sees difficulty in every opportunity. The optimist sees opportunity in every difficulty." So, graduates, in closing, this is certainly not an easy time to enter the field of nursing, but it is perhaps one of the most important times. Your contributions as nursing professionals comes at a very critical time in our nation's history. The essential roles that you play in the coming months cannot be overemphasized. You're being asked to be healers of body, mind, and spirit during some of the darkest days of the pandemic. Our gargantuan undertaking? Absolutely. Worth the effort? You bet. This is meaningful work. So go forth. The world needs you. Thank you.
Hello, graduating class of 2020. Congratulations, you made it through nursing school. So very exciting. I am Crystal Austin, and I am a hospice nurse. I have been a CHANS home health hospice nurse for 11 years, and I have the honor to sit with patients at the end of life. I know you hear the words hospice, and you often attribute it to being about sadness and loss and grief. And although those things are absolutely true and happen in hospice, I find it to be more about peace and love and comfort. It is a true gift to be able to be at a patient's home and sit with their loved ones as they tell stories and be able to help the patient to ensure that they are free of pain and discomfort as they end their final journey. I was thinking about the things that you might want to know coming into this healthcare system, especially during a difficult time of a pandemic. And I want to reassure you that it's going to be okay. More than ever, am I supported by my coworkers and my family to be a nurse. I find it to be exciting to learn new things and be able to take care of my patients despite a pandemic. Wearing the mask and the goggles are not fun, but it's keeping others safe. I often get asked how it is that I can do what I do every single day. And it's simply said that there are some nurses that bring babies into this world, and I just happen to be a nurse that helps them leave comfortably. It has also kept me grounded in knowing what the most important things in life are: your loved ones and your family. It also teaches me to take care of my own emotional and physical well-being to be able to care for others. That's really important to remember, that you have to take care of yourself first before you can care for others as a nurse. I'm so very excited for you to learn new things and to become an excellent nurse. Congratulations again.
Hello, class of 2020. My name is Rachel Keeley, and I'm the Student Nurses Organization President here at USM. While I've had the privilege of knowing a few of you, I don't know all of you. However, what I do know about all of you as a group of individuals is something special. That simply is that your passion for putting others first is what has propelled you into this profession, in a global pandemic nonetheless. I joke that everyone wants a nurse in the family until there's a pandemic going on. Then our loved ones live in fear of our safety and what each shift will bring. As I think about what makes nursing students so unique, it's their unwavering dedication to their studies, their patients, and their future profession. As I wrap together 58 graduation boxes, I couldn't help but think what makes each one of you different from one another. Collectively, I wonder how many family dinners were forgone, social plans excused, and hours of sleep given up because you are simply studying for yet another exam. For all those sacrifices, I would like you all to applaud yourselves. While it may be easy to stand back and picture the perfect undergrad student, freshly out of high school, living in a dorm, and hanging out with your friends on the weekends, that is not what makes USM School of Nursing so unique. I remember in my very first Nursing 100 class, we had to introduce ourselves and why we wanted to pursue nursing. One woman introduced herself and exclaimed that she wanted to be a nurse because she had a child who had spent time in the NICU. At this moment, all of my assumptions about what the traditional undergrad experience looked like were shattered. As you metaphorically look out amongst your peers that you have shared group projects with, studied alongside, and at times even cried with, it's important to note that every single person comes from a different walk of life. Nursing students collectively are a different kind of person. However, my favorite thing about USM is how we all bring a different perspective to the table. Some have mortgages to pay, kids to raise, spouses at home, bills, loans, and last but not least, full and part-time jobs. To be able to balance all of that while obtaining your BSN is no small feat. You are forever a member of this diverse USM nursing family. As you turn your tassel, accept your first nursing job, and study for the NCLEX, there are a few things I don't want you to forget. First, someday, you'll be in the right place at the right time to help someone. Do not question your path, no matter how unconventional it has been and will continue to be. Additionally, everybody is somebody's baby. Treat others with the same care and compassion you'd want your family and friends to be treated with. And lastly, those of us who know you guys are excited to see this journey that you are on. Although we cannot be there together, we are rooting for you. I hope that you will take this quote from a training video about unconscious bias called Drop by Drop and keep it with you through your best and worst days. Quote, we are not responsible for our first thought, but we are responsible for our second thought and our first action. A lot of our personal power can be found in that space between our first and second thought. End quote. As you respond to your first code, start your first IV, or simply sit to pass the NCLEX, just remember, all of us at USM are here, and as Dr. Sue Sepples would say, we are sitting back and sending you love. Thank you.
Hey guys! Can you believe that with less than a year left of nursing school, this crazy virus came to town, and we couldn't finish clinicals, attend labs, or even see each other face to face anymore?
Remember when our amazing professor danced up and down the aisle of our lecture hall, instilling the value of a good cheeseburger for our patients? And when all of our classes went virtual and we were no longer privy to those animations that helped all that complicated information stick in our heads?
We remember it all. We recall the late nights, the group studying, the endless coffee, and the tears.
But most importantly, we remember the camaraderie among our cohort, the support received when one of us tripped, the endless encouragement from nursing faculty, and our resiliency to continue down this new path in our lives in order to be caretakers, healers, and agents of change in the healthcare world.
Julie and I are utterly honored and humbled that you chose us to represent our cohort as class marshals.
We are grateful to all be going through this very much together, as physically separate as we all are.
The year 2020, oh, what a year.
If 2020 were a drink, we feel like it would be a colonoscopy prep.
But the fact that 2020 is really the year of the nurse is much more fitting.
Our favorite quote of the semester is, "We can do hard things." And we know this because we already have.
Many of us still have feelings of self-doubt and feel like imposters as we begin our new careers.
But the reality of it is that each of us has a unique part to play in the healing of the world.
We are no better or worse than the nurse next to us. We each have our own skills and virtues to contribute as one piece of the puzzle, which is what makes us a beautiful whole.
We are proud to stand together, metaphorically speaking, to mark this huge accomplishment in our lives.
For many, 2020 is a year they want to forget, but for us, it's one we will always remember. We never know what the future will hold, and so we leave you with these final thoughts.
You're going to feel like quitting. You're going to struggle. You'll have days where you'll wonder, what's it all for? You'll have days when people attempt to break you down or challenge your intelligence, skills, and right to be where you are.
You'll have moments when you question your own abilities and perhaps your sanity, but you'll rise. You'll rise because your strength as a nurse is not determined by one grade, one shift, or one job. It's an ongoing journey of learning, honor, humility, and a chance to make even the smallest difference in the lives of your patients.
Congratulations!
Congratulations.
I'd like to thank everyone in my cohort. They helped me get by and I wouldn't be here without them. I've made some amazing friends. I'm so thankful for them. I'd love to thank the nursing faculty because the program wouldn't be what it is without them. And I'd like to send a huge shout out to my family and friends, especially Johnny and Camden. Camden always had to hear the words, "I can't, I have to do homework," and she always understood. Thank you all so much, love you.
I'm so grateful for you, Mama, and you're gonna be a great nurse. Love you.
I love you. Thank you.
Yay!
It seems utterly surreal to be at this place, nursing school completed, onto the next venture. I've achieved so much personal and professional growth throughout school with support from faculty and peers, many whom I now consider lifelong friends. And my biggest cheerleaders, my curly-haired clan, John, Oliver, and Simon. My nursing pin is as much a celebration of you as of myself. We did it, gang.
Congratulations, Mommy. You're gonna be the best nurse ever.
We love you.
I just want to thank my cohort, my teachers, and everyone who has supported us throughout the semester. I want to thank my mom and my family and friends. 2020, the year of the nurse. We did it.
Erin, I'm so proud of you. It's an honor to pin you today. Graduation from nursing school. You're going to be a wonderful nurse.
I want to thank all my family and friends who have supported me through this journey.
I'm so proud of you. Very hard.
I wanted to thank my friends, my family, and my coworkers for helping me get through these past 4 years.
Go live.
I would like to thank my family for supporting me every step of the way during this journey. I wouldn't have made it this far without you. To my classmates for always being up for study dates and countless support, you are all going amazing places. And to my lacrosse teammates who cheered on every victory, big or small, thank you to everyone. This wasn't possible without every single support person along the way.
Thank you to my wonderful mom and dad. Your support is insurmountable and my love for you runs so deep. I'd like to thank my sister, brother, aunts, uncles, cousins, grandparents, and friends for your inspiration and love. Congratulations to all of the Winter 2020 USM School of Nursing graduates. Here's to us.
Congratulations, Susie, on your completing nursing school.
We're so proud of you.
This may not have been the graduation we expected, but after years of hard work, we finally reached the end of the tunnel. Thank you to my husband, family, and coworkers for supporting me while I was doing far too much. Congratulations to each of you, and good luck as you find your path towards the future.
I want to thank my family and friends for always supporting me in this wild journey of nursing school. I especially want to thank my fiancé for always believing in me and encouraging me to do my best.
I'm so proud of all your hard work and perseverance.
Thank you.
It has been an honor to live and breathe nursing with my fellow classmates. I have met so many wonderful future nurses during my time at USM, and I can't wait to see where you all go. I could not have done this without my family, friends, and coworkers. I want to especially thank Dr. Susan Supples, Susan Winslow, and Nicole Gibbons for all the laughs and learning you have shared with me. Thank you.
I would like to thank the amazing friends I've met in nursing school over the last few years. I wish you all the best in your future endeavors, and I look forward to hopefully working with some of you down the road.
I'm so proud of you, Jenna, and all the hard work, and you have just persevered, and I'm so proud of you. And I want to give you this pin. Can I?
I would like to thank my friends and my family for supporting me throughout nursing school and always encouraging me to do my best. Thank you so much. I love you all.
Congratulations.
I would like to thank all of my peers, professors, and instructors for providing an encouraging learning environment. I would also like to thank my family and friends for all their love and support, especially my parents, who are the epitome of hard work and dedication. Thank you all so much, and here's to us.
Kat, we are all so proud of the accomplishments that you've had and that you've worked so hard to get here. And we love you very much.
I'm grateful for the opportunity I've had here at USM and for the supportive community that has facilitated this process, including my fellow students, professors, preceptors, and all of the other wonderful nursing faculty. I also want to give a giant thanks to my friends and family for your love and support through this process. Cheers to the class of 2020.
Emma, congratulations, honey, you did it. You're amazing. You will make a great nurse.
Thank you, Mom.
Congratulations, Megan.
Great job. Big
proud of you.
Love you. We're proud of you.
Thank you to my cohort of amazing nursing students. I'd also like to thank my professors and the USM nursing program for their hard work, guidance, and dedication towards shaping future nurses. Lastly, thanks to my family and friends for their love and support. I'm excited to navigate this career in what has been called the year of the nurse.
Congratulations, Julia, on your nursing degree. As your grandmother, I am so proud of you.
I would like to thank my entire cohort. I would also like to thank my entire family for supporting me through such a stressful 3.5 years. I look forward to the future.
I'm so proud of how far you've come, all the goals you've set, and all the accomplishments you've reached. Congrats. I love you too.
My time at USM School of Nursing has been such a pleasure. I have met so many wonderful people, from my classmates to the faculty. I have no doubt that the learning opportunities my classmates and I have experienced while at USM will set us up to excel as nurses in the very near future. This is such a bittersweet moment as this journey is ending, but I'm very excited to see where my journey as a nurse is going to take me. I want to thank everybody from the faculty, my classmates, and my family for supporting me through this.
My name is Lori. I'm Kristen's mother. I'm so very proud of her. As she has continued her nursing journey, I could see how passionate she is for her career. It came easy to her to put her heart and soul into it. She continued her path in nursing even when she came across several obstacles. She never gave up, and she always figured out a way to get through it. And in the end, she has found what she truly loves. I am so proud of you. I love you, Kristen.
Thank you to my friends and family for all of their love and support on my journey to become a nurse. And I'm so grateful for all of the friends that I've made along the way. Cheers to the class of 2020.
Congratulations, Jane, on all your hard work. I think you're gonna be an amazing nurse.
Thank you.
I wanna thank my mom and dad for getting me through these last 4 years. I quite literally couldn't have done it without you. I'd also like to thank the rest of my family and all of my friends for being there through all of the studying and sleepless nights. Congratulations to the entire class of 2020.
You are going to make an amazing nurse.
You're so cute.
I would like to thank everybody who helped me make it so far. My family, my friends, my fellow classmates, the USM faculty and staff, especially at the LAC, and all my other mentors in nursing. I never thought that I would have taken this path in life, but I know that it has made such a difference already.
Congratulations, Mike. We are so proud of you and so thrilled for you, and we love you.
Thank you.
I love you too.
Congratulations, son. We always knew that you'd be doing great things, from the first degree you got in kinesiology to all the work you've done in wellness and on to this degree in nursing. We wish you and all your fellow graduates at University of Southern Maine the very best. I know you'll do well because you're such a compassionate, caring, honest, and ethical man. Thank you and good luck.
Hi everyone, I just wanted to say congratulations to everyone. These past 4 years have been crazy, especially this last year, so we should all be very proud of ourselves.
Thank you to all of my teachers, friends, family, and Scott for all of the support.
Congratulations, Emily. We love you.
I would like to thank my family and my boyfriend. You have been my biggest supporters, and I wouldn't be where I am today without your love and encouragement. Thank you for always believing in me, even when I didn't believe in myself.
I am so very proud of you. You have strength, courage, determination, and have never given up and always followed your dreams.
Congratulations.
First, I would like to thank my husband for supporting me with this goal since day one. I was meant to do this with you by my side. And thank you to our beautiful, patient children who motivate me every day. To my parents, my in-laws and babysitters, and to my hardworking cohort of nurses, this wouldn't have been possible without any of you. Thank you for believing in me.
Good job, Kitty.
Good job, Mom. We're so proud of you. Love you.
We honor you and you are our best. You are USM's best student and nurse ever.
It's true.
Yeah.
I would like to thank my family and my friends for all of your support throughout this journey. I couldn't have done it without you all. I look forward to the future and I wish the class of 2020 the best of luck on all of your endeavors.
Congratulations, Jenna. I'm very proud of you and all your accomplishments.
Nursing school is no joke. I definitely tripped many times, but with the support of my family and friends, I was able to get back up. Thank you for your unconditional love. I am so excited to see what this next chapter has in store for me. Congratulations, everyone.
Congratulations, Sarah. You're going to make an amazing nurse. I'm so proud of you.
I would like to thank my family, friends, and coworkers for supporting me throughout nursing school. Cheers to class of 2020.
You've come in your life and all that you've been through in the last few years. I'm proud for the determination and the drive you've had in nursing school at USM. I'm proud of you. But for the amazing nurse that you're going to be in a short few weeks, I'm so very proud of you.
This has been such an incredible journey. I'm so proud of myself and everyone else graduating this semester, especially my fellow nursing students. Thanks to everyone that supported me these last few years.
I just want to thank my boyfriend Tyler for making me lots of coffee and dinner throughout my nursing school career. Thanks for my dad's support. Love to my mom. I wish she could see this. And shout out to my Midcoast carpool crew. You guys are awesome. Yay, we did it.
I would like to thank my parents, my grandmother, my wife, family and friends, instructors and cohort, all of whose love, encouragement, and support has been so appreciated throughout these years. Thank you all for keeping me going and for always helping me find a reason to smile.
Teresa, you're wonderful. I love you more than anything and you really deserve it.
Thank you. I love you. Love you
all.
Congratulations,
baby. We love you.
Mwah.
Good
thank
decisions
you.
Will take you far.
I want to thank my family, and a special thanks to my husband and two daughters, Cadence and Callie, for always standing by my side and cheering me on. I need to thank my mom for listening to my endless venting during all of the finals weeks, but mostly for never letting me give up. I love you all.
Congratulations, Mommy!
I would like to thank my family for all their support over the last 4 years. I also would like to thank all the friends that I've made along the way, as well as our cohort. It hasn't been an easy road, but I am proud to say that we made it. Congratulations to the class of 2020.
Proud of you and all that you have accomplished. I know the road hasn't been easy, but you did it. I love you.
A rose tribute to our graduates. An offering of a red rose to our nursing students began many years ago with a USM alumni and nurse, Viola Palmese. Vi, as she was known, enrolled in the first NP program in the state of Maine, and she went on to serve over 26 years at the University of Southern Maine. Her caring and nurturing manner served the college students well, as she also served as the school's nurse, where she was known to many as their second mother. A scholarship was formed by the peers of this compassionate nurse, and many have been assisted by her through her giving. The offering of this rose to our students at their pinning ceremonies has proudly been carried for the last 2 years by Emeriti Associate Professor Kimberly Moody. So today, the faculty and staff offer you this virtual symbol and ask that you let it serve as a token of our gratitude to you, to let us help you on your path to a future in nursing, a future that emanates the lifelong career and the founder of this tribute. Congratulations.
On behalf of the Board of Trustees and in accordance with the authority vested in me by them, I hereby proudly confer upon each of you, respectively, according to your individual courses of study, your degree, with all its honors, distinctions, and privileges.
Congratulations, grads. I'm so proud of you all. Your hard work, your determination, your adaptability. As nurses, we need to be adaptable, and you have proven yourselves to be adaptable. You've adapted to flipped classrooms, classes, labs, and clinicals all online. You've embraced the learning and coped with the changes, not only with school, but within your own lives, as we've all been this year. Well done. I'd like to quote Maya Angelou. Open your eyes to the beauty around you. Open your mind to the wonders of life. Open your heart to those who love you. And always be true to yourself. Congratulations.
Hello to the graduating class of December 2020. I'm Professor Linda Samia, and I want to extend my congratulations to all on your many accomplishments. Good luck to you as you join our wonderful profession of nursing. You've worked hard, these have been very challenging times, and you've demonstrated tremendous resiliency. Enjoy all that nursing has to offer. Take care.
Congratulations, class of 2020. You will always be remembered as the nurses who joined the profession in the midst of a global pandemic. And as you leave our School of Nursing, this is not goodbye. You will always have a home with us, and we look forward to seeing you all again. I leave you finally with these words from Florence. Let us never consider ourselves finished nurses. We must be learning all of our lives. Congratulations. We're so proud of you.